All right, today we're going to be looking at storybird.com, and specifically, we're going to be looking at the picture book creation aspect of storybird.com. And so, first, we're going to start off on the read page, and from here, you can specifically look up picture books to get examples of what you're going to be working on. So, all of these books have been created by users, and all of the artwork is available for others to use as well. And so, we're going to use some of that artwork today to create our own short picture book. So, we're going to head over here to the Create tab. We're going to click on that. And then from there, we can choose what artwork we want to use. And so you can scroll around until you find what you'd like. You can search for a specific theme or a specific photo if you've already found one before that you're interested in using. And so we're going to click on this image, Dragon's Den. And so it'll come up with similar images if this isn't quite what you're looking for, but you wanted to narrow it down by, I want this sort of style. And then after you click on that, you are going to click on this little lightning bolt symbol and use this art. And today we're going to be selecting picture book. From the picture book page, it'll pull up your artwork and your story. And it'll pull up artwork by the same artist or art that is similar to the one that you chose so that you have more options instead of just one image when you're working on your book. So when you come over to the cover, you have four different options: classic, landscape, journal, and iconic. Today we're going to go for the landscape option, and we're going to choose our main image to be there. And so here is where you're going to add your title, and you also can add an author. Make sure no last names, only a first name, pen name, or nickname, which is an important aspect of this website. All right, and then from here you can choose the color that's behind your text, and it'll pull colors from the image that you're using. So here I'm going to choose this gold color, and then we're going to move, and we're going to hit this button to go back to our main example. And we're going to start on our first page. And so here is where the editing aspects get a little bit interesting. If you double click on this image, you can change the way that it shows up on the page. So we could make it a full page, we could only have it be on one side, or we could have it on the other side. But all of these options are available on both sides of the page, depending on how you want to lay out your storybook. And we can make it a little bit smaller, or we could have it on the top half of the page, like this, and it all just depends on how you want that image to present. So here we're going to have our text, and then over here with the plus button, you can add another page. And so we're going to drag over this image, and from there, it'll add that to the page, and then we can change how this one appears, or we could just leave it for now and add more pages, get all our pictures on there, and then add the text later. And so I'm going to show you a finished version of these. We're going to save and exit so that we can get back to the main Storybird page, and we're going to select My Story Isn't Finished Yet. So this will save it in your draft so that you'll be able to come back later and make sure that you can edit it and everything like that. And then we're going to click Go to Dashboard. And so once we get back to the dashboard, we're going to head over to the You tab and then go to Your Stuff. From there, you'll have access to your drafts and your previously published books, but right now we're just going to go to Drafts. And after we go to these drafts, we're going to open up a piece that I've written previously. And this piece is called The Fat Cat. So we're going to open this up. And from here, I'll show you what a quote unquote finished story will look like. You'll have your cover. And then from there, you can use these little arrow keys to tab over through your different pages. And so as you go through these pages, you'll see that all of the text formats itself automatically. And then, so I'm going to show you how to publish this. You'll hit Save and Exit once again, but instead you'll publish it. And I recommend publishing it privately. That way, only you and people you share it with will be able to see it, and it won't publish it to Storybird. And then here you can select whether it's for school or not for school, and add a short summary of your story. If you click publish, it will then pull it up, and you'll be able to read through it like all of the other books available on the website. And you will read through it by clicking over on the right or left-hand side to switch pages, and your story is finished.